Good morning, Private.
Welcome back to Sip. I was going to say Sergeant Players, then I realized that wasn't the game title. Welcome back to Game Dev Tycoon. Sergeant Players, our company, has been doing pretty darn well. I mean, we've got a few good games out there. I think we're going to start trying to make a custom engine soon so that we can start making some better games. Maybe get a license for the TES, maybe, unless we have done that already. Did we? I don't know. Let's just go in and see what we've done. Here we are with Sarge in his little seat. Battle Axe is still growing, and immediately the industry is yelling at us. With the growing interest in video games, there's also a growing audience for video game magazines. These magazines are a great way for new game developers to market their upcoming games. All right, marketing is new research. Should we get into that? Marketing? Oh, we don't have the research points for it. It's year 4 already out of year 30, so we do have a lot of, we don't have a ton of time left, but we do have a lot of other stuff to do. So we're going to real quick see if we can do some character design to get some research points, maybe get this contract done. I doubt we'll get it done, because we've done one contract, I think, right? Oh, come on, Sarge, come on, you got this. You got to just keep pumping those balls into that other ball. Just before you do this, I just want to tell you about Battle Axe, because Battle Axe is awesome. Battle Axe is now off the market. It sold 24,850 units and generated $173,978 in sales. That did pretty good. Obviously, we're not going to get this done. Didn't quite do it. We lost $7,000 from that. Let's see if we have anything else we can do. Anything else that's going to be easier? I don't know if that will be easier. No, we're not going to do that right yet. So let's see. If we create a custom engine, what can we put in it? We can't really put tons in it, so I think we're going to wait for that. Let's just real quick develop a new game, just to get us some more money, maybe some more research points. Let's go ahead and let's make a military strategy game. Yeah. We don't have the game link, do we? No. Anyway, a military game wouldn't be good on the game links. Let's make it actually, G64 has gone way down. Let's make it for the TES, because I think that'd be good. So let's call it, Militia in Japan. As a reference to Lovers in Japan by, Coldplay. It's gonna have that song playing, though. It's gonna be like, Lovers, keep on the road you're on. Kill the militia as long as you're in Japan. Alright, so let's start this. Let's make it a 2D graphics game. Military strategy game for young audiences. Let's see. We don't really need a ton of story and quests. We need a lot of engine. We don't need as much gameplay. So let's do something like that, I think. And hopefully we'll get a lot of stuff going. I've already got a bug in the game. Getting some research points. We can research marketing soon. Strategy game, we don't need a ton of dialogue, but it needs to be there. AI needs to be there for sure, and level design can be dropped even a little bit. So, I know I'm going through this really quickly, but I'm just learning even more. Okay, so we have a hint, a goal hint. If I have $1 million, more than $1 million in cash, I will be able to move to the next level. This might sound like a lot, but don't worry. Once you release a hit game, you'll get to this amount easily. So, Militia in Japan is our hit game that we're counting on, isn't it? Yeah. All right, so let's see. Strategy. I think we want world design. I don't think we need as much graphics, and I think sounds we don't need as much of either. So let's kind of... I don't know, let's put graphics and sound pretty darn low, but let's focus a lot on world design in Dev Stage 3 here. Sarge is still piping away. He's just doing so well. He's ironing out these bugs. Just getting them out of there because, you know, we don't want any cockroaches in this game. That'd be bad. They crawl all over Japan and then it ruins the crops, guys, because they just eat everything. Oh, no, it's locusts. Dang it! Vena, the creator of the Master V console, has announced the Vena Gear, a portable console to directly compete against the Game Link from Nintendo. So this is the Sega... what is this? Sega something. I didn't have it. It was something a long, long time ago. So, a spokesperson for the company said, unlike similar devices on the market, which don't come close to the gaming console's Vena Gear, the Vena Gear has basically the full power of the Master V, except that you can take it with you. The Vena Gear also has a full-color screen. So, the other devices on the market is basically just the Game Link, and that's about it. Will his device topple the Gameling? We will see. The Vanagear will debut in 2 months. I don't know if we're going to get a license for that, because we didn't even get a license for the Gameling yet, and honestly, I don't think it's going to do too well. So let's see. Militia in Japan is a new topic, a new combo,
and a great combo.
Our engine leveled up. We didn't hit any records in design or technology, but we're getting a lot of experience. AI leveled up. Maybe Sarge will level up. Oh yeah, he did. He's a level 3 person. He's so good. He's not burning fossil fuels anymore to run his computer. He's using electricity, being so good for the environment. I don't know why anytime you level up, you just have to be better for the environment. Research available, better AI, awesome. So we can make even better strategy games. That's going to be good. We have 43 research points. Oh, I was going to research, but now we're going to look at the reviews from Militia in Japan. Oh, come on. Oh, I was seeing bigger numbers than that. I was seeing bigger numbers than a 5. Oh, no. Oh, no. Is this going to be a bad game? I don't mind getting like a 6 or a 7, but I want better than 5s. Come on, come on. Get like a 7 so we can even this out. Oh, no, I'm not going to get it. Oh, man. Well, we got a 5.5. That's not bad, especially for our first Militia strategy game. I think we're going to research... Ooh, what should we research? Should we research a new topic? What do we have? Fashion? Ninja, racing, and pirate? No, I don't think we want any of those. I think... marketing? I don't think we're going to do a ton of marketing, so I think we're going to do some better AI, and then I think we're going to make a console with everything that we have. I don't know. Console. Engine is what I meant to say. Engine. Can we even make a console in this game? I don't know, we might be able to. If we can, that'd be cool. You know, we'd make, like, the first Xbox 360. Successfully reached better AI. Awesome. Militia in Japan has sold 10,000 in the first 4 weeks, which is great. The Vanagear was released today, so a lot of stuff is happening in the gaming world. Creating a custom engine. I think we may want to do that soon, but if we were to put all the stuff that we have added, it would cost $160,000. So we're going to need to wait until we can get a lot more money. Let's look for some contract work, see if there's anything we can do. We can do that. Yeah, we can do that. It's easy. Let's do that one. Come on, just 7 and 8. Come on, just get a 7 and an 8. You can do this, dude. You can do this. There's no research points being developed. Never mind, I said that, and one was just developed. That's awesome. So we got 17K in that. We are going to need a lot of money to make this engine so that we can make a game off of it. And engines are supposed to make your games do better. So we may very soon need to create another game. Should we make like a sequel to one of our games? Let's see, how many games have we had? Let's go to our game history. We've had Militia in Japan, Battle Axe, Space Chess, Senor Raphael, Troll Playing Game, Cephalopodus X, and Sport of Call. So we've had quite a few games. Yeah, I think it's time to make a sequel. Maybe to Troll Playing Game? Nah, that didn't do too well. Let's make a sequel to Sport of Call. Yeah. Yeah, Let's see. All right. Well, Militia in Japan is off now, off the market. It sold 16,000 copies and generated $113,000 in sale. That's not bad. So we're gonna develop a sequel to Sport of Call. This will be, should we stick with like the ship pun idea? You know, kind of like Port of Call, Sport of Call. Should we stick with that? Jumping off the bow. I don't exactly know why we would do this. What? No, we're not gonna... We're just gonna make a new game. We're not even gonna worry about a sequel to Sport of Call right now. We're just gonna make a brand new game. Nothing we've ever done before. We're gonna make a space game, a space casual game. I feel like it's a bad idea. No, let's not do a space casual. Let's do... we've done everything else, though, so let's do space casual, yeah. For the... You know what? No, let's not do it for the Gameling. Let's keep it on the TES. Let's call it Invaders Form Pocket. Is there a limit on how many characters I can do? Yeah. All right. Invaders. Let's just no. I was going to use Dell as like a from. Yeah, let's do that. Invaders form from pockets. There we go. Because Dell is from in Spanish, if you guys didn't know that. Dell. We're going to target this at everyone. The game is going to be about it's going to be about dust bunnies that come out of your pockets and try to eat your fingernails. And they just the bunnies just chew and chew, and it's pretty gruesome, actually. So now that we've got one design point. The G64 will be taken off the market in 2 months. Oh no, he did so well on the G64 too. Alright, so, let's see. Space Casual, we're going to want a little bit of story and quests, a lot of gameplay, and maybe not so much of the engine this time. But I think gameplay is really going to be very important in this. I'm totally guessing, of course, because I have no idea what the heck I'm doing. Alright, let's see. A casual game, a space casual game. Let's put some dialogues in there. Let's not focus as much on level design, and let's go crazy with AI. So yeah, let's see what that does. Let's see if the AI is a good thing. I know we haven't really put better AI in yet, because we haven't made an engine with it, but we will do that. So let's see, let's just have space. We need a lot of sound for space games, a lot of graphics, and world design too, because you know, you have to design all these different worlds in space that you're going to go to with your lint bunnies, with your dust bunnies that come out of your pockets. We only made one bug in this entire game, and it went pretty well, honestly. I mean, we didn't hit any milestones or anything. Maybe we can just sit here and polish the game for a little bit, and then we'll hit some bigger milestones. Maybe that should do well. I don't know. Let's just see. Hardware manufacturers around the world are surprised today as Govador, the creator of the popular G64, has filed for bankruptcy. Wow. Govador failed to introduce higher-priced alternative and was forced to shut down production of the G64. The platform will retire the market later this month. Aw, man. Well, I mean, that's... I guess it was meant to be, then. Are you just not going to work on this anymore, Sarge? You're like, all right, I'm done. Yeah, look, see? He didn't even do anything in, like, the last 2 weeks. The G64 is no longer supported. We released 5 games for the platform and earned a total of 572K. Yeah. Couldn't pronounce K for some reason. All right, well, I guess we're just going to release Invaders Del Pockets right now. Invaders from Pockets. The game about dust bunnies that try to travel the universe eating everyone's fingers. Fingernails, not their fingers, I'm sorry. We leveled up in gameplay, we leveled up in design. This was not a great combo. We leveled up in world design and graphics and sound, so we're getting a lot of great levels. This is doing really well. We have new research available for a level editor and open world. Ooh, that'd be good, open world. Yeah, that'd be nice. Alright, we have reviews from Invaders Del Pockets, and they are not looking good. Not bad, not good, said Star Games. Oh man, I saw a one there for a way too long. Uninspiring by Informed Gamer. It wasn't meant to inspire. It was meant to have people push buttons on a TES. Game Hero said it was okay, and our best review came from All Games that said it falls a bit short. So this was not a very great game, in all honesty. We haven't even sold... we sold just over 3,000 copies in the first week, which is not bad, honestly. Let's see if we can find some contract work. Just to get ourselves a little bit more money, even. No, that's it. That's all we can do is those two. Well, we can't do that for sure. Can we research anything? Do we want to research anything right now? Do we want to research stuff for our next game? Like maybe open world? Yeah. Let's do open world. Oh wait, that's $40,000. Jeez, no. Let's just research a new topic. Let's research ninja. Ninja. We'll make our next game is gonna be a ninja game. Yeah. It's going to be an awesome ninja game, too. It's going to be like a ninja game about food. What? It's about the way ninjas eat their food. They cut it up with their katanas, and then they throw it against the wall and hit it with a shuriken, and it sticks there for a while. Even Sarge is not entirely sure what I'm doing. He's scratching his head all the time. We finished the topic, though, so that's good. Alright, so it looks like Invaders Del Pockets is going to come off the market just right now. It's gonna fall a bit short, like All Games said it would. It sold, however, 9,735 units, which is a lot more than I thought it would sell. And it generated 68,000 in sales. So that's not bad. That's a pretty decent game. We need to get right back on it, though, Sarge. We need to make a ninja action game for the... do we want to make it for the Gameling? Yeah, let's do it for the Gameling. It's got a lot of market share, so maybe that means it'll do a ton better. Let's see. The game is going to be targeted at everyone, and it's going to be ninjas in the day. Because ninjas are always, like, currently at the night, but this is what happens in the daytime when they fight each other in broad daylight. Yes, it's going to be a 2D graphics game, and here we go. Starting the development. We already have a little bit of points. We are going to do not as much story and quests and go crazy on engine and gameplay. And, I think that seems pretty good. I think it seems like a good idea. Already got a bug in the game, which is not good, but we are getting a ton of points going everywhere, which is awesome. Let's see. We don't need any dialogues at all. We're going to put some level design in there. We don't need as much AI, because it's going to be just you fighting people in broad daylight. So, you know, anyone could do that, so you don't really need a lot of intelligence. We are getting a lot more technology than we are design right now, though, so I don't know. We might hit a milestone in technology then. We're going to do not as much graphic, because it is a handheld game. Also, not as much sound. World design, actually, no. On an action game, let's go crazy with graphics and keep world design and sound kind of low. Yeah, let's see what that does for an action game, because I've always thought that action games should be amazing in their worlds, but not so much in their in the way the world sounds. What? I don't even know what I'm talking about. However, we are very low on cash, so we are going to need to release this game right now. We just put a bug in the game, as I said, we were releasing the game. So that is some crap right there, but we did hit some milestones. We had a new topic, a new combo, and a great combo. Oh man, that one bug, I'm gonna be really mad about that bug. Oh man, Sarge, what are you doing to me, dude? We leveled up to level 3 in story quests and dialogues. Sarge is slowly making his way to a level 4 person. He's getting older. He's getting better. We have research available for simple cutscenes and better dialogues. Awesome. It's good. I'm really upset about that bug still, though. Dang it, that bug is going to annoy me. There's like that one spider in the game that just tries to kill everyone by accident. First reviews for Ninjas in the Day came in. It has been... Oh, I'm seeing bigger numbers. Oh my gosh. No way. An 8. Star Games loves it. Yes. Yes, we did it. Oh my gosh, this could be an awesome game. Ninja in Action is a great combination, said Informed Gamer. They didn't say anything about the game. They just kind of gave you general knowledge there. Game Hero found it very enjoyable, and All Games finished up the straight 8 with a very good. Guys, this is our best game yet. We got a straight 8 for this game. Yeah. We're going to come out of the red. Oh my gosh, yes. 10,000 in this first week. Yes, we did it. 10,000 sales in the first week. We're rank 11, guys. It's my favorite number. I like that. I like that. Seems that the initial sales for Ninjas in the Day have fallen way below expected numbers. What are you talking about? It's like 27,000 sales, girl. What are you talking about? The game received outstanding reviews, but it seems that the chosen platform isn't... The gameling isn't popular with everyone? What? That doesn't make any sense. That doesn't make any sense at all. Everyone had a Game Boy. Kind of. A little bit, yeah. Let's do some contract work. Let's do some game backdrop. Maybe. Maybe we'll be able to do it. Oh, no. We might not have enough time. I didn't look at the time. Oh, no. Well, it's going to get us some research points, if nothing else. Oh, come on. Finish. 2, 1. Yes. Oh, yeah. We did it. Got us another 16K, girl. Oh, we totally have enough to do our engine now. So let's do it. Let's make our engine. Going to put 2D graphics in there. We're going to put mono sound in there. Linear story, save game, gamepad, and better AI. All right, this is going to be a good engine, guys. Oh, crap. Oh, dang it. I didn't even name it anything. I didn't even name it anything. Game Engine 1. Well, I guess it's good. It's a good start. I'm now creating my own custom game engine. Once the engine is finished, you'll be able to use it when creating new games. Game Engine 1. That's the best idea I've ever had. Ninjas in the Day has achieved a company sales record with over 50,000 units sold. This is an important milestone in the history of Sergeant Players. Heck yeah, it is. Heck yeah. The Vena has announced that they will be... releasing a new game console in 2 months. The Vena Oasis comes with 16-bit graphics and sound, which promises a new kind of gaming experience. Ah, the Sega again. I don't think this is the Genesis, is it? Like, I think it was the Sega Oasis. It was something like that. Sega released something before Nintendo did, but Nintendo came back with the Super Nintendo and it just blew them away. Vena said at the announcement, the Oasis is a new start. It will be the Genesis called it. Of a new generation of gaming consoles, and we believe it will do very well in the market. Some of the games already announced for the console suggest that it will appeal to more mature audiences. Okay, so we can make, like, M-rated games for that. That's gonna be good. Sarge is scratching his head. He's not even working on custom game engine 1. And, what was that? I think people are screaming in my house, so I'm sorry if you hear them, but people don't like me. Or anything that I do. Everyone hates me. Ninjas in the Day is now off the market. It sold 56,516 units and generated almost $400,000 in sales. Guys, that was awesome. That was good. That was a good game, guys. That was really good. We should do this more often. You and me, man. You and me. Yeah. We have a proposition that is in Swahili. Okay, we can decrypt the message. Do you have, like, a decryptoman? I'm Decrypton Man. This is a very special offer. Our agents have recently managed to borrow some research information which might be of interest to you. If you're interested, then transfer 14K to the enclosed uplink uplink location. We'll contact you, Agent Blowfish. That is the best name ever. Do we want to do it? It's only 14K. I mean, we have a lot of money. Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it. Enlève Vierge 3 et LP 6 KZ equals. Thank you for your business. You have successfully researched law. Law? Wait, is that like a topic? Wait a minute, what? What the heck is law? What the? We are a lawyer now. 100K engine. Invest over $100,000 in a new engine. Wow. My new game engine number one, is now complete. Awesome. Congratulations, your first game engine is now ready. You should try using it in your next game. Alright, that's cool. Well, real quick, I want to see if law is like a topic or something. Oh my, it is, but it's like all the way down here. That's so dumb. Okay, so, let's see. Now that we have our new engine, we should research. Let's see, what can we research? Let's research something else for our next engine soon. Let's do open world. Yeah, let's put that in there. Alright, we can't make a new game yet, but once we do, we will use our new engine. We might, if we have the money, get it for the Vayno Oasis, because that's probably going to have a buttload of market share. And the best thing is that, you know, if we never actually want to spend a ton of money on a license, we can always just use the PC or TES for a new thing, because, you know, we have licenses for this. All right, so let's develop a new game. Let's make a... okay, let's see. Should we make a law game? No, that's a dumb name. That's a dumb idea. Let's make a fantasy RPG game. I think I may have done this before. Let's do it. The Gameling still has a buttload of market share. The TES actually has very little market share. This time, let's make it for the PC. Let's make it a young game. Let's make it on the Game Engine 1. And let's call it The four dudes. I'm calling it that. That's amazing. That's the best title I've ever thought of. Welcome to the four dudes. The four dudes. That's gonna be the intro of the game. The four dudes. Okay, so we can use 2D graphics V2 now in the four dudes. That's awesome. Let's do this. Let's make the four dudes. The four dudes. I don't even know what that's supposed to mean. Alright, so RPG, we want to go nuts on story and quests. We want a linear story, we want to be able to save the game, and we want to use the gamepad. I shouldn't have made this for the PC, dang it. Let's bring gameplay down a bit, and let's bring engine down a bit. Actually, even below story and quests, for sure, and gameplay. Engine doesn't need to be focused on a ton. But, that is what we're going to do, and hopefully that will be a good idea. Getting some research points, getting some design and tech points, just scratching my head, because I obviously have dandruff. I don't ever wash my hair, I never leave my computer screen, I just sit in this sweater vest all the time. Alright, so RPG, we want some dialogues, we actually want a lot of dialogues, and we want some AI. Level design can kind of suffer a little bit, but better AI is going to be in the game. Just because I've always found RPGs, like Skyrim, if you consider that an RPG, I do. I've found games where there's amazing AI to be awesome. Like if the AI can like say to you, hey, you need to do your homework, because you're sitting at a computer screen playing a game and you have homework to do because it's not summertime. If that's how smart the AI is, then you know you've got a good game. Let's use mono sound this time instead of basic sounds. Let's go. Let's just go full on everything. Let's evenly distribute all the stuff. See if we can get some good stuff here. Wow, we definitely hit a design milestone, and I think we hit a technology milestone as well. Just ironing out the bugs, and then we're going to release it. Put another design point in there. Let's go. The Fardu is ready to hit the market. We only have $52,000 left over, but we hit both new milestones, like I said. Don't think we're going to level anything up. I don't think we have enough experience in anything else. We are getting not a ton of experience and stuff, though. Oh, look, we get graphics experience for whatever graphics we use, too, though. But yeah, as you can see, we didn't get tons of experience and stuff. So let's release it. We now have the joystick available, which is going to be good when we get, like, the... what's it, like Xbox and PlayStation and stuff, so that you can use like thumbsticks and stuff. The first reviews for the Fardu came in. Alright guys, the Fardu is gonna do very well. That's my prediction. Oh my gosh, I'm seeing 10s. Oh, we got a 10! It's the best of its kind! It's the best of the Fardu! Oh, it's almost perfect by Inform Gamer. Dude, oh my gosh, this is amazing. It's a great game according to Game Hero. Star Games gave us a 10, and so did All Games. All Games said it was awesome. Oh my gosh, guys, we did it. We got a great game. It's a hit game. Oh my gosh, look at the sales. Over 50,000 in the first week. It's the number one game. Oh my gosh, guys, we did it. We freaking did it. The Fardu has achieved a company sales record of 100,000 units sold. It's an important milestone, guys. It's very important. You should write it down in your calendars. Today, on year 6, month 5, week 1, we were informed that the Fordu has made an important milestone in the Sergeant player's life. Yeah. New office? Congratulations, you've made quite a name for yourself and have saved up quite a lot of capital. If you want to grow the company farther, then moving into a new office is the next step. Yeah, I found the perfect office situated in Technology Park. Would you like to move your company to the next level? I don't know. Let's move. Alright, well, this is a nice office, isn't it? Welcome to your new office. Now that you have a bigger office, you can also hire staff and forge a world-class development team to make even better games. Awesome. You may now also train yourself and your staff to improve skills. Okay, let's try this by completing a management course, which is required before you can hire your first employee. To get started, close this message and click on your character to bring up the training menu. Alright, so, okay, now we have a training menu. That's cool. Let's see. Staff management is the course we need to do. So, the Fordu is still selling. According to our market research, the recently published game, The Fordu, is a surprise hit with players. The developer, Sergeant Players, is fairly new to the gaming industry, but we cannot wait for what they will develop next. People are all over this. Look at this. We have 3,000 fans. It's still the number one game. The freaking PC game, The Fordu, with gamepad support, is the best. Oh, dang it. Now something else passed us. The Fordos must have passed us. Yeah. Well done. You've successfully trained your management course, and you're now able to hire your very first employee. To get started, close this message and click the full position button, which is visible near the big desk. I think we'll do that next episode, guys. This has been a very long episode. I'm sorry for making you guys wait so long. But, yeah, I think we're going to do that next time. The Fordu will probably still be selling by then, since it's selling like crazy. So we're just going to end there for now. Like and favorite if you enjoyed. Comments, keep the series going. Let me know what you want me to do with it, or if you even want me to do this. If you want me to do something else, let me know. And I will, wait a minute. Okay, so we sold a buttload, and we gained a buttload. That's all we need to know. Subscribe to Compartment Army, and I will see you all next time. Eddie's Privates.